Hi guys, this is Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're going to go over a topic that can really make a powerful difference to your video. If you've been in the world of video editing for any amount of time, you might have heard the terms L-cut and J-cut used before. We're going to quickly go over what they are, how to use them, and why they can make such a big difference to your next project. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is a quick refresher on what L and J-cuts are. Simply put, these kind of video cuts are ones that have either the audio begin before the cut, or continue to trail on after the visual video cut has been made. Let's take a quick look at each. Here's a quick example of a J-cut. In a J-cut, what you do is have the audio for the next clip available and audible before the actual cut takes place. In a sense, it prepares your audience and gives them a bit of a taste of what's going to be shown in the next shot. The reason it's called a J-cut is because on the editing timeline, when you have an audio clip prior to the video cut, it sort of makes this janky looking J. Kind of. And the L-cut works pretty much the same, but with the opposite taking place. Having the audio from the first clip trailing over into the next shot. On the timeline, this makes sort of an L shape. Here's what it looks like in a more common and less obvious example.
It's part of being human. If you wait to be perfect before you do everything, you're never going to do anything.
In this example, we see that the audio from the first character's take continues on, even though the shot has switched to the person that they're talking to. These are really simple principles, but they can help to immerse your audience into the world of your video. It can really help to hide the point at which your dialogue tracks switch from one to the other. Or it can build anticipation for your audience to see what's going to happen next. Either way, it's a useful technique to know how to put into your videos. The best part is that it's crazy simple to do. If you're doing a dialogue scene and you want to make an L cut, just have your two video and audio clips on your timeline. Now select your rolling edit tool, either from your toolbar or by hitting the shortcut key N. Now take your cursor and hover it over the audio cut. If your audio and video are linked together, you can unlink them by selecting them, right-clicking, and selecting unlink. With your rolling edit tool, hover over the cut between the two takes and drag it over to the right, making the video of your subject talking cut before the dialogue finishes. You can then finesse the point at which the other shot jumps in by shifting it around or even using the slip tool. But you've done it. You've made the audio trail past the cutting point, effectively making an L cut. Great. Now for the J cut, let's take a look at how I did the first example. We have our first piece of footage here and our second piece right beside it. The audio actually wasn't taken from this video clip. I downloaded it from motionarray.com and put it in separately with the waves. The concept of L and J cuts can work even for elements that aren't ultimately from the same source. Even though our audio was captured separately, the J-cut can still work to build anticipation for the next clip. Just place your audio file down and have it start well before your video cut. Fading in gradually also helps to sell this effect. It's honestly that simple, and it makes a huge difference to how professional your project feels. It's also a concept that when you master it, it can be applied to so many other techniques inside of Premiere. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, we've got a lot of other tutorials here on our YouTube channel or over at motionarray.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.